Another day, another question and solution on the certified Q&A for the Google Cloud Platform Associate Cloud Engineer. It's very important to the process of understanding Google Cloud and passing the certification exam that you go through the question and attempt answering it yourself first. So pause the video, work through the question. We'll catch up in just a little while and I'll show you how I do it. In this scenario, your company has reserved a monthly budget for your project. You want to be informed automatically of your project spend so that you can take action when you approach the limit. What should you do? A. Link a credit card with a monthly limit equal to your budget. B. Create a budget alert for 50%, 90%, and 100% of your total monthly budget. C. In App Engine settings, tail a budget at the rate of 1 by 30th of your monthly budget. Or D. In the GCP console, configure billing export to BigQuery, which is a great analytics solution, and then create a save view that queries your total spend. In approaching this question, the key requirements would be, one, of course, there is a consideration there is a reserved monthly budget. And the key requirement is that you want to be automatically informed of your project spend. So you are looking for something like alerts. The system should be able to inform you as and when the budget that you've set is slowly getting exhausted. Let's look at each of the answer options in turn. How would it work if we linked a credit card with a monthly limit equal to your budget? What are all the problems that could be there for this? I immediately see many of them. One, of course, is that you're going to have to manage almost a credit card per project. The overhead of just managing that itself is not going to be worthwhile. The second thing is how the credit card might not have a credit limit that is bigger than the budget you plan for. Now, you could do that, but if the spend increases way more than what was the expected budget, remember that Google Cloud is not going to necessarily shut down your project. Right? So the cost will continue to incur and you're going to be charged an overdraft fees by your credit card company, which of course, as you know, is going to be extremely high. So there is a potential problem that your credit limit could exhaust quickly and then you overrun the limits of the card. Another problem I see is when the billing happens. You do not have any intermediate indication of how much spend is happening until the end of the month. It is only going to be at the end of the month that a bill is going to be generated by Google Cloud, and then that is going to be sent to your credit card company, and then the attempt to pay that automatically. Maybe it's going to be too late before any of these happen, and then you realize, oh, you've actually overspent on this project. So given all these, it is fairly clear that your management, your CFO, is going to be very unhappy with this approach. And therefore, we can eliminate this because clearly it does not give us frequent updates or updates at certain chosen points when it informs you how much of the budget is being spent. And that is a key requirement, right? You would only get it at the end of the month. And there are other problems as such with having an external option to control the budget within your project. How about option C? In option C, the suggestion is first that we do something in App Engine settings. Now, nowhere in the question does it actually say that this is related to App Engine itself. So already there is an indication that this might not be the right option, right? Because App Engine settings does not control the whole of the GCP project. Even so, we will look at the remainder of the answer option to evaluate whether there might be something interesting. Now, what would happen if you took the entire monthly budget and then averaged it out over the number of days that you have and set that as a daily limit? One clear problem with this is the expectation that you're going to spend only a certain amount consistently through the entire month, irrespective of what day it is. This is a false assumption. It is expected for a production project that you're going to see potential spikes during certain times of the day or during certain days of the week. It would not be the right assumption to say that you're going to have a consistent spend every day. For example, if yours was a recreational app which got used more during the weekend than during the weekdays, then you should expect to see a huge spike during your weekend, Saturday, Sunday, whereas the rest of the week it is going to be a very low spend. On the other hand, if it was an office app, you should expect to see huge usage during the week, but very low usage during the weekend. So planning for an average of the month for every day is going to either be under budgeting or over budgeting. The bigger problem in this is, of course, the under budgeting, because you're probably going to have huge spikes that you've not planned for. So clearly, this is not a preferred option. You cannot guarantee that the daily usage is going to be 1 by 30th of the monthly budget. How about option D? In option D, there is the option to configure billing, export to BigQuery, which you can do. You can export all your billing information to BigQuery and analyze it there. But what I see here is that you've got a large amount of manual work before you get this alerts coming to you. You will need to write the code, you'll have to maintain it after that, and you will have to manage how the alerts are sent, whether to email or SMS or to your other tools like PubSub. And I'm thinking, you know what, this is roundabout, and is there an easier way? Billing cost control is such an integral part of running your cloud app or the production servers these days that I would expect that any decent cloud provider worth their salt would provide the solution as a built-in service. You shouldn't have to build this custom solution to manage and control your spend. So given that expectation, I'm going to eliminate this just because it's too roundabout, and I would expect Google Cloud to have that as an option. Which leaves us with the final option, which suggests that we just create a budget alert at 50%, 90%, 100% of your total monthly budget. It seems the most apt answer, and given that we've eliminated all the others, I can safely say that this is the right answer. Yet, let us just go confirm that. Looking at some of the documentation and white papers from Google Cloud, here is an excerpt that I'll read out to you. Controlling spending with programmatic budget notifications and automated budget actions make it easier to stay within defined budgets and increase predictability. That's exactly what we want. So within Google Cloud, there is an option that allows you to track your spend, monitor the usage, and also have alerts sent to you as the usage is approaching certain thresholds. How do you do that on Google Cloud itself? The way you do that is to go to the console. On the top left hamburger menu, you click on billing, then budgets and alerts. And in stage 3 of this, you can choose what projects to apply this budget to, and within that project, which all products should it cover. In my case, I've got about 6 projects, and I've said apply this budget called monthly budget to just one of those projects and to all products that I'm going to use within that project. Thereafter, you can set the target amount, the total expected spend. And in the next slide, you can say send me alerts when the usage reaches 50%, 90%, 100% of that planned amount. You can trigger these alerts under two circumstances. One, when that budget is actually reached, when that much amount is actually exhausted, in which case you choose actual. Or when it is expected to reach very soon, in which case you're going to choose the option forecasted. So given all of that, it is now clear that our option B was a correct one, because Google Cloud provides this, and it's very straightforward. It's a service provided by Google Cloud itself that we can just click and deploy. What are the key learnings and takeaways from this question? One, there is an option for you to set a budget and also have alerts sent to you automatically as and when certain amounts of that budget are exhausted. You can and should set alerts at various percentages of your budget so that you can track and replan how to change your allocation, the budget allocation for that month or period. This allows you to control runaway costs. You do not want to be hit by a surprise bill at the end of the month for a huge amount. Ideally, you want to be informed on an ongoing basis so that based on that, you can say, hey, you know what? I can either increase the budget or reduce the budget. You can also control and figure out if there have been some malicious usage by maybe people outside the company or people inside the company. How would it help you replan the budget? For example, let's say you set a budget of $3,000 for the month and you realize that your app has become extremely popular and there's a huge number of users coming in suddenly, and maybe your budget is exhausted within the first 3 or 4 days of the month. In which case, it helps you replan and say, I'm going to spend a little more. I can plan to spend a little more if that is what you intend to do. You could do it the reverse way also, where if you plan for $3,000, but within the first, say, half of the month, you have only spent about $100, you could potentially say that given that half the month took $100, the remaining half is probably going to take $100, and now you can adjust the budget downwards. So setting alerts, setting a budget, and watching those and replanning your spend is a very good practice within any cloud service and, of course, within Google Cloud. One tip on the approach, how I answered this question, was that I eliminated options, not using, say, technical details, but using more common sense. It is not that you cannot set some of the other options and make this work, but we want to eliminate options that are too complicated if there is a direct option within Google Cloud. We want to eliminate options that just don't make sense, like linking an external credit card. And we also want to know what is supported within Google Cloud itself. Say, for example, App Engine settings is not where you want to control all the costs for your Google Cloud project, because App Engine is just one of the solutions provided among this huge set of other solutions. I will leave you with some references. Now it's time to subscribe to all the great content we've got lined up for you to learn Google Cloud and to help you with the certifications.